Popeye the Sailor Man, their first game was like Pac-Man. But this is the sequel, I'm telling you people. It's Popeye the Sailor Man, it sucks.
So, what better way to start off a game than punching a crab in the face? I mean, who doesn't have an urge to do that once in a while? It's fun! This game kinda has a Mario Land vibe. Maybe it's your level design, maybe it's your graphics. I mean, these blocks are literally the same as in Mario Land. I'm kind of expecting a mushroom to pop out and make Popeye a giant. So, I'm walking along picking up cans of spinach when... What the fuck? What happened to his arm? I know Popeye is strong, but his arm is bigger than his entire body. What was in that spinach? Steroids? Either that, or he's had an extreme allergic reaction. It's kinda like if Mario got a mushroom, and he just grew a giant foot. And then, if you keep eating spinach, he starts shooting it out of his body, like he's just had too much, and his body is physically rejecting it. But instead of barfing it all up, he just shoots it out lightning fast from his armpit. I think that's a sign you should stop eating spinach, but I guess it would hurt having a tin of spinach thrown at your face. And to keep the Mario Land comparisons going, sometimes a star will come out of a block and make you invincible. Real original. Could've at least made it, a bigger can of spinach or something. And then, I reach the end of the level, and you slowly walk through a door. How climatic. Wait, deja vu going on here. How exciting. Mario just slowly walks through a door. A bit anticlimactic. Heck, why stop there? Might as well copy the bonus level too, right? And at around this point I realised, Popeye never puts his arm down. Maybe it's shaped in such a way that is physically impossible. It'll probably lift his whole body up or something. Or maybe he's just very proud of it, and doesn't realise he's a freak of nature. Even when he climbs ropes, he refuses to use two hands. And check this out. That's disturbing. So, I haven't really mentioned it, but the story is basically, you find a map to Treasure Island in your attic, and you follow it. Cause it has to be a legit map, right? Anyway, that's all well and good, but why then is the first boss a giant fucking snowman? Popeye fighting a snowman? Well, at least he's not fighting a goddamn xenomorph. And yes, this is a real game. What is it with old games and bloody xenomorphs? Well, at least I did the first world. Oh. 1-4? What kind of game has another level after the big boss? I wanna play world 2, dammit! Oh god, this music is terrible! Make it stop! Make it stop! And these climbing controls are even worse. He barely grabs onto them. Sometimes he just falls down. And when you jump off, you expect him to jump, but... nah, again, kinda just falls down. I hope they don't focus too much on these ropes later. Next level, and it's a goddamn underwater level. Why did developers back then think they needed water levels in every game? Who's the idiot writing letters to companies saying how great water levels are? No one likes them, and this one's even worse due to how Popeye moves. He kinda just jumps around super fast when you press the button. It's the most rigid swimming movement I've ever seen in a game. I'm surprised he doesn't just float to the top actually, considering how big his arm is. Okay, I'll stop talking about his arm now. Well, I suppose I got to punch a shark in the face. That kinda justifies this level's existence. But that's nothing, cause in the next level, you get to punch a ghost in the face. Fuck the Ghostbusters, Popeye is the right idea. Face your fears with a fist to the face. So believe it or not, I've actually really liked this game up to this point. But World 3 just takes a big dump on everything. It's like they took everything bad about the game and crammed it in one world. In fact, it's basically a whole world based around super annoying rope jumping. Seriously, these are really, really annoying. Just look at this jump. Fuck! God damn it! Yay! Fuck you, bird. And these guys think they can beat Popeye in a fist fight. Have you seen the size of his fist? Idiots, all of them. And what the fuck is happening in his dying animation? Boss time! Yeah. Okay. It's a dinosaur. Why is a dinosaur on a pirate ship? It looks like they stole the sprite from another game and just shoved on another head at the last second. It doesn't even join up or anything. And it's one of those shitty bosses where you can't really hit them without getting hit yourself. Bit of a pain in the ass. But the whole world is a pain in the ass, so at least it's suitable. I can tell you this though, I'm not looking forward to World 4. Oh, it's just World 1 again, pretty much. It's not even harder or anything. I guess they rushed it. I mean, the demand for a new Popeye game must have been overwhelming, so they had to get out as soon as possible. Can't blame them. Still better than World 3. Final boss time, everyone. And what is this? Battle of the Giant Arms? I mean, as you may have noticed by now, because I've never mentioned it, Popeye's arm can grow pretty big. But this guy, Jesus Christ, man, that's not normal. It must really get in the way having a hand that big. I don't even want to think about it, really. And after the final battle of awesomeness, the ending awaits. What wonders await in this treasure chest? Gold, perhaps? Riches beyond your wildest dreams? An alien? Nope. A single can of spinach. Time well spent.